Functions and classes. Now that we have gained a basic understanding of the syntax of Python, meaning that we have gone over strings, numbers, different data types, for loops, if statements, while loop, we are now ready to move on to the next section, which is function and classes. Function and classes are important within programming, especially object-oriented programming. And I have found this little sentence from Tutorials Point, which is, by the way, a great way if you want to learn about Python even further or just want to learn another programming language, then try visit the site. But I have found this sentence, and they stated very well that a function is a block of organized reusable code that is used to perform a single related action. Functions provide better modularity for your application and a high degree of code reusing. So what is a function? A function is basically what's let us define a piece of code that can be called, like we have been calling variables before in this series. So as you see here, you can have a class which contains different functions. So a class, for example, could be a person, and this person have some properties associated with him, like variables we have seen before. So every person should have a name, for example, a profession, and some skills. And when you create a new person, meaning that you initialize a new object called person, you then assign these values to this person. And the reason that classes are so damn good and that object-oriented programming is so popular is because you don't need to create a new person whenever you need one. If you have an application where a lot of persons are going to be created, you can just use the same code and just create a new object and assign the values to that object instead of having to rewrite multiple persons. So instead of copying this piece of code, we can use the same code to initialize all the persons that we want. And then a person can have some skills. So in this example, there is function add skills, meaning that a person can have some skills added to him, and this is really the core functionality that functions do. So you can create a function and then call it multiple times, all the times you basically want, of course depending on the context in which you have implemented it. But then we can skip copying code around, and as we have seen before in this tutorial, we have been using the print function. So instead of writing all the functionality behind the print, we are just calling print or length and append and so on. These are really functions that we are just calling, and they are working out of the box because someone else has written the functionality behind it. And that is what we are going to learn in this section, how we can write our own functions such that we can call this functionality and do some processing within our code without having to rewrite our code a lot of time. And then we will be looking at classes such that we can create new objects of classes and make our application more object oriented. So see you in the next lecture.